One, two, three, four, five. Okay, pivot table in Excel 2010. Have an Excel file here with a list of the statistics for goaltenders for the Toronto Maple Leafs. I put in some dummy data here at the beginning for testing purposes. Right. So suppose we want a pivot table. Click on the Insert tab here, and click on Pivot Table icon here. It sees the data and asks you, do you want to have it in the same worksheet or do you want to have it in a new worksheet? So we say New Worksheet. Then the data, let's say the wins. I'll drag wins to here. For columns, I want the year, so I'll drag year here. And then for rows, I want the last name, so I drag last name in there. So you see here we have the last names, right? So there are three goaltenders with the last name Marks. So they've all been added together. And you can see the years, and the last column is the total. So for example, for Roach, the total number of wins of all years added together is 80, right? For the Marx brothers, their total number of wins altogether for all Marx brothers is 16. Now, another example, if I want to do first names, I'll go Insert, Pivot Table, New Worksheet. So this time I'll do first name for the rows, year for the columns, and let's do losses for the data. And this gives me this second pivot table here. I'll just change the name of the tab. And there are two goalies with the name Johnny, right? So they've been added together here, right? But the three Marx brothers are separate here because they have three different first names, right? So that shows you how you can slice and dice your data different ways depending on what criteria you use. So that's a simple example of a pivot table. Thanks for watching.